Hi, this is Patrick Kalanji with Letterhead Fonts. Today I'm going to be showing you how to use LHF Black Rose Script. This particular font has three versions. It has a regular, a shadow, and an inked version. I'm going to be showing you how to layer the regular version on top of the shadow version to make a design. We're going to be using Adobe Illustrator and Adobe Photoshop. I'm going to start off in Adobe Illustrator.
I've opened a new document and I've chosen the font LHF Black Rose Script Regular. I'm just going to type out the word classic. One of the features of this font is there's many automatic ligatures. You'll notice that if I type an S and then another S, it'll change to the SS ligature, which gives the font a more hand-lettered feel. Next, we're going to stack our regular on top of our shadow, so grab your direct selection tool, copy the text, Control-C PC, Command-C Mac, and then we're going to paste it behind, Control-B PC, Command-B Mac. With the text in back selected, we're going to change the color to black. You notice if I zoom in, it did change to black, but the other text is in front of it. If you go up to your text palette, you're going to change the font to LHF Black Rose Script Shadow. Now that you've stacked the fonts in Illustrator, you could convert this to vector outlines and add any effects that you want. Next, I'm going to show you how to stack these fonts in Photoshop using the Layers palette. I've typed my text out using a little bit brighter and a little bit warmer yellow color here. To stack fonts in Photoshop, you have to use the Layers palette. So we're going to grab our classic layer here, and we're going to drag it into the new layer icon to duplicate it. Then drag it just below the original text layer. Double-clicking the T will highlight all the text on that layer. We're going to change the color of this layer to black, and then I'm going to change the font in the text palette here to LHF Black Rose Script Shadow. Click anywhere in the Layers palette to deselect that text. And there you have it. You've stacked the regular on top of the shadow. Next, we're going to take this top layer and we're going to duplicate it because we're going to make a little design out of this. So grab that topmost layer and drag it into the new layer icon to duplicate it. Then turn off the layer right below it. Right-click on your top layer. Go to Rasterize Type. I like to rasterize the type just in case we need to make any color changes to it later. Make a mask of this layer by holding down Control or Command on a Mac and clicking on the thumbnail within that layer. Now the reason we've made a mask of this layer is because we're going to make an inset to go over the top of the text here. But first we're going to need to contract the selection we've made by going up to Select, Modify, Contract. I've contracted by about 8 or so. Hit OK. We want to put this inset on a new layer, so create a new layer by clicking on the new layer icon. For our inset, we're going to be doing an orange fade from the top to the bottom. So choose an orange color. And then to do the fade, we're going to grab our gradient tool. Up in the gradient tool's options, make sure that you're fading to transparent. Then on our new layer, you're going to click and hold right above the mask and then drag to the very bottom of the mask and let go. Hit Control D to deselect the mask. Command D for Mac.
The shadow version of this font already has the outline built in, which makes designs like this fairly quick to make. Black Rose Script is also perfect for designs that require a hand-lettered feel. Download this and other fonts at letterheadfonts.com.